Coming up next on The Voice of Alabama Politics, more strange scandals. Also, the V-Team takes a look at high-kicking Ivey. And can Luther Strange, with the help of Donald Trump, pin Roy Moore? I don't see the president, but nice shorts there, Luther. All this and much, much more coming up next on The V. Of Alabama Politics, where we tackle the tough issues so you have the hard facts. I'm your host, Bill Britt, and as always, I'm joined by the V-Team. All men today. Yeah.
It's a GQ men's hour.
Yeah, or the Burly Bear Club. I'm not sure which.
We're okay. Well,
everybody except me.
Yeah,
I would fit.
Whatever. All right. Well, Kay Ivey, new polls show that Jack is just killing it. I mean, you know, folks say, well, she hadn't been in governor that long. People know Kay Ivey. They have an opinion about Kay Ivey. And right now she's polling about 84% favorables. Her closest rival, which is Tommy Battle, is 55 points down.
Well, she's a well-known entity in Alabama.
Right.
She served in government for time in memoriam. And she's done nothing wrong as governor. She's done nothing, but she's done nothing wrong.
Well, I'm going to take exception to that. She has done some things that, you know, we thought, not such good ideas, some of her hires. And she's done some things that have given people confidence that the state's moving forward.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. She made some questionable decisions with the monuments bill and the adoption bill, in my opinion. But all in all, I think, you know, she stayed out of the spotlight. She's not appeared corrupt. She may have some ties to BCA, but most people don't see that.
Josh, it's a low bar, isn't it?
Yeah.
You got Bentley, you got Riley, it just goes on back.
Yeah, she's figured out the secret here, which is stay out of sight, say nothing controversial or do nothing, and just lay low.
Announce a whiskey factory in Troy.
You know, and that's, I think, the success of that method is apparent in the fundraising.
Favorite
the 2 weeks
ever.
That she had the committee, she raised over $1 million and is beating Tommy Battle, who started fundraising at the beginning of the summer.
Well, she's running as an incumbent.
Right. Yeah, it's a lot easier to raise money as an incumbent.
Yeah, and she's got the bully pulpit right now. And I don't think Battle or any of these guys necessarily need to get out of the race. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I just think that they need to, let's face reality. It's going to be a slog. They'll have to go negative, and that's going to be tough.
Well, you know, as she said, no steps too high for a high stepper.
So, well, that's true. That's true. I want to go to the lottery. One of the things that has been on our minds and on a lot of voters' minds is why can't we have an up or down vote on a constitutional amendment to allow us to have a lottery? Susan this week broke down a lot of the talking points that people use against the lottery, and she also broke down what needs to be done to move it forward. I mean, Chip, this opposition based on moral grounds, I mean, it really is kind of, I mean, it's a little bit strange to me because we already have gambling here.
Yeah, we already have gambling at all of the Indian casinos. You can also go 20 miles over the border and get a lottery ticket in Georgia, and that's what people do, and they spend all of their money over state lines, paying for other people's education, when we could have it here. Mm-hmm. And I think if you walk out on the street and you ask pretty much anybody, unless it's like a Roy Moore Baptist, about the lottery or gaming, most people are going to say, at least we should be able to vote on it. And if not that, then they probably support it. So,
I mean, some folks say, Jack, that but we've introduced legislation in the past and it didn't work, or it went too far, or it didn't go far enough.
Well, when people tack on their little personal pet projects and all that on, mm-hmm. we had a clean bill that gave us an up or down vote on a lottery, I think it would pass overwhelmingly.
I mean, the polling, Josh, shows mm-hmm. that people want it.
Yeah,
Republicans, too.
Sure. It's very popular. It is a little bit more complicated than what people put into it. And you also have to keep in mind, there are a lot of people making a lot of money off of this fight continuing on, okay?
Right.
There are a lot of people that every time these things fail, they can just keep putting it up the next year and the next year, and the casino guys keep putting money into this thing to try to get it legalized. And so Chip's right about people going over, across state lines and buying lottery tickets and stuff, and we're funding them. What we often leave out is whenever this is brought up, people talk about the downside of gambling, and they talk about the problems and, you know, the addictions and things like that. Well, we're missing that money that treats that stuff. All of the portion of, in every state around here, there's a portion of that tax money that comes off of gambling that goes to the addiction centers, that goes to those helplines, that goes to help people out when they get themselves in those problems. We don't have any of that, but we have all of the gambling that they have. And so I think when we talk about it, that's something that some people should start to point out a little bit more, is we've got a lot of people addicted to gambling and no place for them to go.
Well, a lot of people that are addicted are going to go across the state line,
sure.
or do mm-hmm. it here. It's yeah. not going to stop them that it's not here. They're going to find a way to do it.
Yeah. That's right.
And laws are, I've said this all along as a good part of me as a libertarian, laws are created to protect me from someone else. They're not created to protect me from myself.
Exactly.
Well, and I agree with you 100%. And, you know, the other battle is who's going to get a casino and who's not going to get one and all that. And that, those are the things that the legislator has to address. And I'd mm-hmm. like to see it sooner than later.
Yeah, and they also have to address where the money goes, because when Governor Bentley brought up the lottery, he wanted to use it to pay off the shortfall that we had. So people are going to be mad if it's not going to education or if it's going to the general fund. That's all things that they're going to have to figure out. We've been doing this for how many decades?
A long time. Yeah. A long
and
time.
And we're falling behind a number of states. If you look at what Georgia has been able to do with that Hope Scholarship Fund over there, and the way that there's a generation of kids now that have gone to college, of poor kids that have gone to college in Georgia, and that's part of the reason why they are surpassing Alabama in a number of different areas in terms of workforce readiness there, is because you have those kids. Tennessee's going to be the next one because they're offering free two-year college at this point for everybody.
Well, and we can't even pay our bills.
No.
So, I mean, it's obviously we're either going to have to raise taxes, bring in more revenue, and I know they've said, well, we just create more jobs and all that stuff. That's a lot easier said than done.
Yeah.
One super casino could in Birmingham could raise all kinds of jobs and all kinds of revenue.
Why don't we pass a law that prohibits Indian special interests from giving money to political campaigns?
I'm okay with that. I mean, the Philip Kinney and Allison Kinney be upset. But,
well, they'll still have a job. What
well,
the hell?
Well, let's hope so. Still got a friend in Robbie, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to leave it right there. You're watching The V, the voice of Alabama politics. We'll be right back with more news and analysis.
I'm Roy Moore, and I approve this message.
Of course, I'm frustrated by the false negative ads. What we need to do is get on with the business of this country. Repeal Obamacare, build the wall, reform the tax system, and get rid of the IRS. The Republican establishment has failed us. I fought for this country in Vietnam. I fought against liberal judges in the courtroom, and I'll fight for you in the United States Senate, so help me God.
Please vote on Tuesday, September 26th.
America is counting on you.
As Miss Alabama 2017, one of my goals is to help our state be the very best it can be. One of the most effective ways to make that happen is by participating in the electoral process. I'm Jessica Proctor, and I want you to obtain a government-issued photo ID that you can use when you vote. Register to vote and join me in making a positive difference for Alabama.
Lawson's Aesthetics and Med Spa is a one-of-a-kind medical spa offering a portfolio of rejuvenation services and advanced technologies to enable you to feel younger and look fabulous without the need for invasive surgery. Owned and operated by licensed physician Dr. Heather Lawson, the Lawson's Aesthetics and Med Spa offers advanced therapies for women and men to revitalize body and mind. Discover what you and Lawson's Aesthetics and Med Spa can accomplish together. It's your life. Live well, live strong, and live beautiful.
The voice of Alabama politics. Josh, this past week you wrote a story where we found in the archives Bentley's notes on the selection to replace Jeff Sessions as U.S. Senator. And there were a lot of notes in there about General Strange, a few notes about everybody else. But give us a kind of a breakdown of what that story was about.
Yeah, it was essentially his notes on how he came up with this weird process and scoring system that managed to get Luther Strange into that seat, and some of the notes that went along with that. And they were very, very, very detailed about things, almost to the point where you would think, man, who would write that? You know, who would write, for example, that Luther Strange said he could do more for me? That was one of his quotes. I could do more for you in the Senate. And then in parentheses added, for the state, you know, and then afterwards added roads and et cetera, just to make it clear that there was no quid pro quo going on there for the thing. It was so contrived and so over the top with the details that it was like all Bentley scandals. It was just one step too far that got him in trouble.
Yeah, you know, all the bullet points about Luther Strange, there was how many of them? And then you get down into Connie Rowe, and there's like two or three.
Yeah, poor Connie Rowe. Oh, she stands by what she believes, and that was it.
Well, Jack, it tends
and
to...
And Perry Hooper's a showman.
and he has got a show. And I like Barry.
Listen, if anybody thought that anyone other than Luther Strange ever had a chance to get that appointment, you're crazy. Huh. Because he wanted him gone. He wanted his boy, Steve Marshall, in there to the point, as we understand it, that he interviewed Steve Marshall to be a special prosecutor to prosecute or look into prosecuting Luther, Alice Martin, Matt Hart, etc. And when that didn't go through because his legal counsel thought it was a bad idea, he had his own scheme.
The crazy thing is that Marshall actually was going to do it, was going to accept the job. And now this guy is the Attorney General of Alabama, who is going to go after the people who are going after Mike Hubbard, the crookedest politician we have had in this last two centuries.
Well, we knew this was messed up from the start, because you're letting a guy go to the Senate so that you don't get prosecuted.
Right.
And then you get to appoint your own guy who would have to prosecute you. That just in and of itself, you don't even have to get into the weeds of it for that to be.
So I personally don't think there was a quid pro quo between Luther and the governor. I think the quid pro quo was between the governor and Steve Marshall.
Well, I don't know.
Maybe not the real legal sense of the word quid pro quo.
Well, all we know is that Bentley, Luther told him he could do more for him.
Yeah.
Parentheses, the state, for you in Washington.
Maybe so. I mean, maybe remove quid pro quo out of it. But no matter what, Luther Strange knew that was the wrong thing to do, to take that appointment out of that. He knew it beforehand and had said as much. And so that's a problem. And I'm not convinced that Steve Marshall wouldn't jump off a building to stay as AG over there at this point. There is nothing that he won't do.
Oh, no. This guy'd crawl over broken glass. Luther'd lick the floor at the rotunda at the Capitol to stay there.
Have to work a real job again. Right. I'll do anything.
I mean, you know, so, I mean, that's what we got. Yeah. You know, any Bentley appointment pretty much needs to be just washed off with the latest dung that comes out of the goat hill. This week they had the Senate debate between Roy Moore. There's, you know, visitors from all over. The president came. Sarah Palin came. I don't know, Chip, if it does any good. I think this cake is probably baked.
I agree.
It's baked with congratulations, Roy Moore.
Yeah, there is just so much disdain for Washington and so much disdain for lobbyists. And honestly, that is what Luther was. That's what Luther is. That's why Bentley said in the note that he could do more for him in the Senate. I think people are just so disgusted with the way things have been going that they want somebody else. And Roy Moore is the only person who, and I never agree with Roy Moore hardly, but he is the only person in Alabama state politics that has risen to that position that, you know, you can almost say he's not going to take a bribe, he's not going to do the corrupt thing. And I think that's what people want.
Well, as the only person on the panel that actually agrees with Roy Moore on some things, not all things, but I think he's honest. And I don't think you can say he's not honest. I mean, he won't steal from you, Jack.
I don't think we ever have to worry about that. But I think if he wins this thing Tuesday and you're upset, I think you can lay it at the feet of Kay Ivey for moving the date from 2018 to 2017, because the only two people she thought probably she was helping Luther, but I don't think anybody thought Roy Moore was going to get in. Yeah. It ended up helping him because he didn't have to spend money.
I know. I talked to Ivy's people, and I talked to John Merrill, and they told me they did it because the law says it has to be forthwith. Yeah. So it's forthwith that did him in.
It depends on how you define forthwith.
Well, if I owe you a million dollars, I'm going to pay you.
I mean, having the election was fine. And if it ends up with Roy Moore, it ends up with Roy Moore. I mean, you know, he's going to show up with his handmaid to tell people that they're coming to vote for him. And they're going to come and vote for him no matter what. And
Handmaid's Tale. the movie.
And that's what they're going to show up. Those people are going to be there every single time.
But what I'm saying about why she didn't leave the date, which gave a lot of other people an opportunity to get well-known and raise money and all that, but it only ends up benefiting Roy Moore, which is, I'm with you, if he's elected, he's elected.
I think there's a legal argument to be made that this is what should have happened. I mean, I think it's a fair debate back and forth, but I think reasonable people could look at that and say this is what should have happened.
And if he wins, he wins. I just hope he doesn't ride a horse to get sworn in.
You have to look at the spirit of the law because this was supposed to be a special election, and you're not supposed to have 2 years to campaign.
Right, that's right.
I mean,
they were giving, Bentley decidedly gave Luther a huge advantage.
And would really, more of Luther Strange would have been better, you think?
Well, I don't think either one of them is going to do a bad job.
It would have helped Luther because no one knew Roy Moore was going to win. But it would have helped Luther more. If Roy wasn't in it, setting it up early would have, it helps Luther.
Well, we're going to have to leave it right there. You're watching The V, the voice of Alabama politics. We'll be right back with more news and analysis.
Our criminal justice system, when it goes wrong, can go wrong horrendously.
Should the prosecutors be in jail? Yes, they should be in jail.
That's my body, but we know she's lying.
The government spared no resources.
One purpose here, and that was to keep that man from being the governor of the state of Alabama.
No doubt in my mind that Don Siegelman was rogue.
They had to get rid of him because they couldn't beat him fair and square.
I'm Roy Moore, and I approve this message.
Of course, I'm frustrated by the false negative ads. What we need to do is get on with the business of this country. Repeal Obamacare, build the wall, reform the tax system, and get rid of the IRS. The Republican establishment has failed us. I fought for this country in Vietnam. I fought against liberal judges in the courtroom, and I'll fight for you in the United States Senate, so help me God.
Please vote on Tuesday, September 26th.
America is counting on you.
Okay, ready?
Ah! Oh, my goodness! Yay!
be the voice of Alabama politics. They've asked me to remind folks to go vote on Tuesday. The special election will be Tuesday. Mm-hmm. And they also said that I needed to remind folks that we are featuring the film next Sunday about Don Siegelman, mm-hmm, and his prosecution. I think we're going to have around 1,000 people there. We still have 200 seats left. You can go to our website and click on the ad and come see Atticus versus the Architect. Josh, you've seen it. It's pretty good.
I mean, it's very, very good. And there will be a lot of familiar faces to people. If you follow politics around, there'll be a lot of familiar faces in that documentary that share some information. And it's a pretty good movie. I mean, I can understand why certain people don't care for it.
Well, it got banned here because, Laura Canary doesn't come off in a very good light.
No. She really does not. And there are some other people who do not come off in a very good light as well. But it is very good. Very kind of eye-opening movie to help people understand a few things.
Jack, you coming?
Yeah, I'll be there. Okay. Bell's on.
Good. I guess the whole V team will be there. Mm-hmm. I'm just holding off. I want to watch it with the whole crowd. But we've got a bunch of folks, politicos from the right, left, center, are going to be there. And the tickets are...
I texted Carl Rovin and invited him, by the way.
Did you?
Yeah.
How's Carl?
He seems to be doing well.
That's good, the architect. I didn't get the Atticus part. I wasn't buying the Atticus part. That was the bridge too far for me.
I think so, too.
Maybe Harper.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't know. I tend to think there is absolutely no hope for Doug Jones, even though I think he's a great guy, as becoming U.S. Senator from Alabama, if he takes on Moore or Strange. But Josh, a big name, Joe Biden, still the guy, the go-to guy for the Democrats right now, former vice president, long-term senator, and a heck of a good guy.
Yeah, and I think you'll see a few other big names coming along to campaign for him in the state, because... He does have a shot. I mean, you look at the polling on this, and the polling of him up against either Moore or Luther Strange, statistically, kind of a dead heat there. Will he win? Probably not. But the fact that we're talking about that in this state, given the history and where things were just 7 years ago, with the storming of the state house and how you could every moron with an R beside his name got elected by standing there, I think it shows somewhat of a shift in attitude.
Do you think it's because we no longer have a black man in the White House, that we don't have a black president, that the Democrats are not being as vilified as they were?
I don't know about that. I mean,
oh,
I think
Josh, I can't believe you don't have an opinion on that.
I think it's just when you're the minority party, you're automatically not going to be in the crosshairs as much. I think I think you're right. I think this election is a lot more about setting up an infrastructure for future elections.
I would think Doug Jones would have a much better chance without bringing in people like Biden and other prominent Democrats. That's only going to remind people of what party he's tied to.
Well, could he get President Trump to come down for him?
I don't know about that.
I don't think Alabama is as Republican as it appears in elections, because the Democrats have such a terrible turnout operation. Mm-hmm. There are more Democrats than
and
you would think.
And terrible candidates like Hillary Clinton.
I don't want to adjudicate the 2016.
Yeah.
President Trump came down to lobby on behalf of Luther Strange. What do you think? Did it help Jack or hurt?
We don't know yet, but I think people have already made up their mind in this election, because it's just, I think we're all sick of it. And Republicans are going to say, I like you, Don. You're a great president. You're my guy, but I got to go against you on this one.
Chip, I know there's some polling numbers that you found very interesting, and in light of Doug Jones, I think they are relevant.
Yeah, it is relevant, because if you look at the poll numbers right now, the most recent poll that we've seen, almost a third of both of the candidates' supporters said they would vote for Doug Jones over the other guy if their candidate lost. And I think that's going to play a lot into it when we get past this primary runoff and get into the general election. I personally don't think Doug Jones has a big shot, but it's always possible in Alabama. Well,
Jack, you've seen a lot of races. What do you think?
Well, Moore is a very polarizing figure. There's no doubt about it. If the Luther people and the Luther people end up being really upset after this primary, if some of them turn on Doug Jones, that's going to help him, sure.
Wouldn't you say, though, if it Moore wins this, and which, I mean, kind of looks like that's what's going to happen, but if he does, does that not help Doug Jones more? Because it seems to me that the Luther people are more of the center.
But there are not that many of them, Josh.
Yeah, that's the problem. Who
that's
are
the problem.
Luther?
But not that many of the Moore voters. Look what happened in his last Chief Justice race against a little-known candidate from Birmingham there. I mean, he barely beat him.
You know, but I think that, you know, you've got to look at the, if we look at the raw data that we have, mm-hmm. in the primary elections, mm-hmm. Democrat and the, I mean, the Democrats, there were like 100,000 fewer Democrats
sure.
went to the polls than Republicans. So are we thinking at all that the Republicans who voted in that primary will split off and vote Democrat in the general?
I think it's possible, but that's also because the Democratic primary was just not contentious at all. It mm-hmm. was Doug Jones, and you're not going to go out and vote when you know who's going to win. And I think going back to what's going to happen on Tuesday, we have to look at what Mo Brooks supporters are going to do, because they're going to split either way, and it depends on how many of them go for Luther and how many of them go for Moore.
I would say
and what
a vast majority of them go for Moore.
Yeah, yeah, I would say that too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And that's going to help them.
Yeah, I don't think that it's necessary for them to go and vote for Doug Jones in that. If they just don't go vote, will help out a whole lot.
Especially if more Democrats come and start helping
well,
Doug
Luther's
Jones.
People may very well stay home.
Well,
after if he loses the primary.
Well, there are a group of Republicans that are anybody but Moore.
Mm-hmm.
And I know a bunch of them. A lot of them are younger people,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of them are people that are not that are more centrist.
Yeah, yeah,
they will not vote for Roy Moore under any condition.
The idea of him being in D.C. there scares a lot of them for the future of the party in this state, because it does. No matter what you think about Roy Moore not being a crook and being honest, his rhetoric in a lot of cases does set us back a long way. And it paints this state, if you send him there, it paints this state in a very bad light nationally.
As a business interest, you would probably say, I need to put my money either on Luther
mm-hmm.
or Doug Jones because of that very reason. But we're going to have to leave it right there. You've been watching The V, the voice of Alabama politics. You watch us because we watch them.